Hello, goods and goodnets. Welcome back to Fan Spotlight. Today we'll be looking at SZA's Control and Kali Uchis' Red Moon Venus. If you're new to Fan Spotlight, these are quick cuts of reviews and my reactions to whatever you guys recommend me. So first off, we have Control. I have listened to SZA before. I listened to SOS. I thought it was pretty good. I've never really listened to much of her other discography. So we'll be looking at one of her other popular albums, Control. This is 49 minutes long, 14 tracks. Let's get started.
That's my greatest fear, that if I lost control or did not have control, things would just, you know, it would be fatal.
Let me tell you a secret. I've been secretly banging your homeboy. Why you in Vegas?
Okay. I think like one of the things I liked about SOS was she has really good flow, and it really fits with her really fits with what she's going for, and I think I'm sensing that here too, and the voice delivers. It's very quite interesting instrumentation. There was a lot of that on SOS, which is what I liked about it. Yeah, that's good. All right. Good first track. Love Galore, featuring Travis Scott. They've, as far as I know, they collabed a lot, SZA and Travis Scott. I don't know. I never listened to Travis Scott either. Ooh. I feel like she's got the singing voice, and I think there's a lot of like rap flow to it. Sounds good. I know I'll go back to those, like voice and flow. But I think that's what I like about her music. Fits really well with the song with the beats and instrumentals she goes for.
Now it's a problem. Oh no, it's gonna be in a rut. Be in a mess.
Let me come inside. Let me pass it inside. Hey, yo. What? Excuse me? I mean, they actually really sound good together. He uses like a certain delivery. Cause I listened to SOS and he did like featuring two songs, and he sounds really well. They sound well together. So weird, cause I know a little bit of Travis Scott's music, but I don't really listen to it. That was really nice. I did like that. Kendrick Lamar. I do know Kendrick Lamar. I listen to him. And I think I know where this is from. Yeah. I've heard this sound before. The sound, not the song. I listened to it fully. I didn't know it was actually a song that he featured on, not a song that he made. Ooh. Layers. Like layers.
Nigga, niggas to lose their mind for it, wine for it.
Time for it, pussy. Trying to see no color line for it, pussy. No bank can have and go by for it, pussy. See, it was calculating. This is rather dangerous.
So facetious. The heavyweight champ. Pussy is so
undefeated. This very sounds like, damn, Eric Kendrick. This was 2017.
You can never trivialize, pussy.
Damn.
But a bum nigga like you,
that was good.
I know what you really about. Hikey, your f*** is weak, buddy. It's all
really, a lot of funny lyrics. I mean, like, in a way, like, it just comes off funny. I'm not sure if that's the intention, but it's funny to me. Your dick weak. Very great R&B. Wow. Same. This sounds really great. I think I'm liking this more than SOS, honestly. I mean, I did like SOS. I like this one. I think I like this more. Maybe I need to re-listen to SOS. It has been a while. I think, like, the problem with SOS, I think it was just a lot of tracks. And because a lot of the tracks, and because it was a lot of tracks, I think some just came off as filler. Not really sensing that here exactly. Maybe not yet. Not exactly. Perhaps. We'll see. But I'm liking all of this so far. Ooh. Alrighty. This feels very, this feels very high school teenage girl. Not a criticism, just sensing the sound. Yeah. Oh yeah. High school teenage girl. It is called prom. So far away. I like the ad-libs. I can sense a vibe. I can feel it. But I don't think it's something I'll listen to. Yeah, not exactly my thing. Yeah. I sense the vibe, but not really my thing. The Weeknd. Not The Weeknd. Literally The Weeknd. That's like when I thought, because I was at a vinyl shop, and I saw this, I saw this on vinyl. I was like, oh, featuring these songs. And I saw Weeknd, I was like, oh, The Weeknd's on this? Like, The Weeknd? But no, it's literally just a track called The Weeknd. I can't read. These glasses mean nothing. Nothing. It's quite a lengthy intro here. Let's track. How long is this? Oh. Ooh, that bass really kicks in. Boom, 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 boom.
I just keep him satisfied through the weekend.
Ah.
Days I need feelings before them.
That's fair. I mean, I don't know the full context. But you're like 9 to 5 on the weekend. Yeah, because 9 to 5 you work all... I mean, why am I thinking hard about this? It makes sense. I mean, it makes sense on the surface level. I don't know. I'm overthinking it. Silence. Interesting outro. This is a massive nitpick, but I don't think I would have had that at the end of that song specifically. Massive nitpick, by the way. Don't listen to me. I don't have opinions. I don't have opinions you should trust. Me with opinions? Listen to the song. That's right. No, nobody belongs to anybody. Okay? Nobody should be an item to a person, nor should you be an item. I just kind of said the same thing. All I'm saying is, don't try to claim people as an item. That's toxic. Don't treat others like an item. Life lessons with Nick and SZA. That was a nice little track. Transition. Okay. Odd choice a bit too, honestly. Very the beat is seems very rap oriented. She's still kind of singing on it though. Again with the singing voice and rap flow. Wow. I like that. Wow. Wow. I think I like this. I think the beat's kind of throwing me off a bit. It's still sounding nice to me. I think I'm starting to reach some filler tracks here, honestly. Actually, no. Maybe. Put a pin on it. In 12 hours? Working 12 hours is crazy. Hey, it's that sound. I know that. Part. Okay, ignore that I say filler, because I am liking this. I think the instrumental is less distracting than the previous track. I like this. Oh, wow. I'm not yawning because of the album. I'm yawning because it's 9 at night. Video game music? What does it sound like? What am I thinking of? What am I thinking of? Sounds nice. I feel like there should have been like some sort of effect there. But there wasn't one. Interesting choice. Very nice drums here. Nice little track. I think I like it. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, no. There we go. Interlude. I don't know who James Fauntleroy is. Easy bake, easy wake. Ooh. This sounds good.
Somebody show me the ropes, babe.
Wow, even for an interlude, I did like that. Like that. Hmm. Yeah, okay. We're on the last three tracks here. Cool. How long are these? 4 minutes. Okay. Cool. Normal girl. That type of girl. That you can show off. This is actually quite interesting. So kind of just without the fantasy of her. That's what I'm getting at here. This does sound good. This is actually interesting to hear. Ah, I get it. Wow. It's interesting perspective. Good way to put it. Pretty Little Birds. This sounds good too. Oh, is this album gonna go out with a bang? Still open to flying with someone. Whoa. Hey. Wow. That sounds really... Wow. Isaiah. That sounded good. Oh, man. Sounded really good. I really like that. Been through things, but still open. Yeah. I see that in the lyrics. This is the last song. 20-something. I'm turning 20 this year. Jeez. Seems to be a guitar closer. Yeah. Describing how it is to get to your 20s. Ugh. Again, I'm turning 20 this year, so I don't know how it's gonna go for me, really. It's very similar to the first track. I think that's fitting, though. Oh, like that.
And if it's an illusion, I don't want to wake up. I'm gonna hang on to it. Because the alternative is an abyss. It's just a hole, a darkness of nothingness. Who wants that? You know? So that's what I think about control. And that's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
That was beautiful, Mommy. That was perfect.
Oh. That's nice. Wow. You know, very tie between this and SOS. Listening to this now, I think I can hear like the improved sound onto SOS. A lot more evolution in that album. Like, it's still good sound, and it was able to evolve, and it was able to evolve more in SOS. But they still both sound really good together. That's one tie between them. Because I do like tracks here. There's some tracks that I don't like as the other ones. And the same goes for SOS. But this was a good listen. Bring some perspectives in. I was reading the descriptions on Genius. Bring some interesting perspectives. All in all, that was a good listen. I did like that. Let's move on to the next album. All right, here we go. Red Moon in Venus. I thought it was Red Moon Venus. Red Moon in Venus. This is about the same length as Controls. For me, Kelly Uchis, I've only heard, like, I listened to Moonlight. That's a good song. I like Moonlight. But I never really, like, listened to her anywhere else, really. So, experience is really, really small. Not like, it's not like I've listened to like her previous works on like other works unlike what I had for SZA, which I listened to SOS first and then Control. Let's see how this goes. First track, In My Garden.
Hello.
So very
Can you hear me?
Intro.
I just
very intro. Oh, how nice. Okay. I wish you roses. Kylie has a good voice too. Oh, I like that. Sounds good. So, already off, second track. Letting go of people without resent. Omar Apollo, I do kind of know him. I haven't really listened to his stuff though. It sounds nice. This all sounds about right. Like that. Yeah, so Omar was just kind of uses a vocal layer in a chorus. Thought he would get a person. Should probably listen to him more. Does sound good. True. A lot of times. Two human beings can be so wonderful. I like that chorus. Just so, so beautiful sounding instrumentals so far, and her voice fits so well with it. Oh, so good. So it is very much, I guess in general, love album. Ooh. Very nice. That outro's good too. I'm liking this album so far. All mine. Yes. I was talking about like the segue into the lyrics, by the way. Just sounds so good. Don Toliver. I've heard of him. I don't listen to his work though. Oh wait. They're dating. Oh shit. Huh. Oh. Nice that I have a song together. I did not know that. I don't know, Again, I don't know a lot about a lot of artists, especially not these two. So a little bit of a surprise, a little bit. I see. So still a little bit of, so yeah, there was always be like squabbles or miscommunications, but they'll still go strong. Very nice, very nice. That's a good song to include, especially here. I know Spanish. Como te quiero. I don't know Spanish. Yeah, como te quiero. I'm saying it right. I think. I don't have an accent. Ooh. Wow. Nice little track. I'm liking all of these songs so far. Wow. Yes.
Whatever makes you feel better, paint me as the villain if that makes you feel better. Make everyone hate me if that makes you feel better. At the end of the day, she eat my pussy if I let her. At the end of the day, she trade lives with me if God let her.
Oh shit. Damn. Going off. She was going off there. That was good. Alright. I literally, I like heard the melody ahead in my head. I like that. Feel karma when you're all alone. Moral conscience. Knowing your worth. Wow. Sounds so beautiful. Production and her vocals. Fantastic stuff. Interlude, not too late. I like those switch-ups with her vocal delivery. I like those. I think there was that other one earlier. I forgot which track, but there was that other one earlier, which I also like. I like those switch-ups. Those are good. I'm gonna hear more of those. Not too late to love. Not too late to admit you love. Very good interlude. So getting more into the feels with this one. Like having a high standard for your partner. Or not standard. More like a pedestal. Yeah, that's this tone switch up, tone and voice, or what it actually be called? I don't think it's tone. It's either way, it's a switch up, a little bit of a switch up in vocal delivery. That's good. Bit more into the feels for so far from what I've gathered from this album. It is very much an album about love. The connection and the intimacy. Summer Walker. I don't think I know her. This one sounds a lot more different than the other instrumentals here, but it still sounds good. Very, good choice to put this after Blue. What do you see from the lyrics? Yeah, this is a very much different instrumental. But it still sounds good. So now dismissing, letting go. Realizing they didn't deserve you. I very much like this. This is good. Hold on. Okay, I feel like that last part. I think there could have been another, like, a vocal switch up there. Vocal delivery switch up. I think that still works. That still works. I like it. It's a bit of, like, a personal nitpick choice I would have done. But that still works. I had to pause a little bit. I got a brownie. Around my favorite. Moonlight.
When I'm in all these, I know kiss, looking dolly, I think I may go out tonight. I just wanna ride, get high in the moonlight.
Ah, so good.
My lover, pero yo no me can cuando miro el espejo, kiss, looking dolly, I think I may go out tonight. I just wanna ride, get high in the moonlight.
Very interesting choice that was put after Blue and Deserve Me. So good. Alright, on the last song now. Quick change there. A little more poppy. Oh wait, Steve Lacy was supposed to be on this track. Huh. Reading the Genius descriptions. I should start doing that for the rest of the albums I'm gonna listen to on the series. Okay, yeah, I see this. Ready to love and forgive. Yeah. This is a good good song to end it off with. Quite a big change from Moonlight directly after. But this is this track is definitely more poppy than the rest. I hear it. Same. That's good.
I've gotta free my mind. Just wanna remember all the good things.
That's good to end things off with. And ocean sounds. Wow. I
love that. I love that. That was beautiful.
Very, very, very good album about just love and connection and intimacy in general. It's very deep down and knowing your worth. I really love that. Just really, just very nice production, instrumentation, and her vocal delivery is on point. So smooth, and a lot of good messaging on this album about love, connection, intimacy. I really like that. Wow. So that's gonna be it for today's fan spotlight. We went over SZA's Control and Kali Uchis' Red Moon and Venus. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, subscribe to keep up with new content, and ring the bell for notifications. I'll see you all later.